Hello friends. So here in this question, we have to evaluate limit x tends to minus 1, x cube plus 1 whole divided by x raised to 4 minus 1. Now before solving this problem, if you'll observe the given term, then you'll find that it is algebraic function. And whenever we have algebraic function, then we start with direct method. And if direct method is giving us the answer, then it's fine. But if direct method fails, it means if we are getting 0 upon 0, that is indeterminate form, then we look for other methods. So let's start with direct method. So here I'll say, let L equals to this limit x tends to minus 1, x cube plus 1 upon x raised to 4 minus 1. Now, by direct method, here we'll get minus 1 the whole cube plus 1 upon minus 1 raised to 4 minus 1. So, by direct method, I'll say here. So, now, this term will become minus 1 plus 1 and minus 1 raised to 4, that is 1 minus 1, and it will give us 0 by 0, which is called as indeterminate form. And as I said, whenever we get indeterminate form, we look for some other method. Now to decide about other method, we'll again observe the given question. Now here, in the numerator, we have the term x cube plus 1. So I can rewrite this as x cube plus 1 cube. And I can find out the factors for it by using the formula a cube plus b cube. Similarly, here in the denominator, we have x raised to 4 minus 1. For which also I can find out the factors. So here we'll apply method of factorization, where we'll find out the factors of numerator and denominator. We'll cancel the factors which are same, and for the remaining terms we can again apply the direct method. So therefore, by method of factorization, this will become L equal to limit x tends to minus 1, x cube plus 1 cube. Here I am applying one formula, and that formula is a cube plus b cube. Now the value of a cube plus b cube is a plus b, a square minus ab plus b square. Now here we have a as x and b as 1. So that will become x plus 1, that is a plus b, a square, here a is x, so x square, next ab, that is x into 1, again I'll get minus x, plus b square, that is 1 square, which is nothing but 1, upon. Now for this x raised to 4 minus 1, I'll rewrite this term as x square the whole square minus 1 square the whole square. And here I can apply the formula, that is a square minus b square, which is a plus b and a minus b. So here we'll get limit x tends to minus 1, x plus 1 as it is, x square minus x plus 1 upon, this term will become x square plus 1 and x square minus 1. Because here I am applying the formula a plus b and a minus b. So a is x square and b is 1 square, which is 1. So a plus b will give us a x square plus 1, and this a minus b will give us x square minus 1. Now after this, if we'll try to cancel the factors from numerator and denominator, there is no common factor, but we can still further divide this x square minus 1 term by using the same formula a square minus b square. So this term will give us x minus 1 and x plus 1. So we'll get next step as, therefore, L equals to limit x tends to minus 1, x plus 1 as it is, x square minus x plus 1 as it is, then x square plus 1 as it is, and here I am writing that formula, which is a square minus b square equal to a plus b into a minus b. Now, from numerator and denominator, we can cancel the term x plus 1 and x plus 1. So, after cancelling x plus 1, we will get these three terms. So, I will rewrite the term and it will give us x tends to minus 1, x square minus x plus 1 upon x square plus 1 and x minus 1. And here, I will apply direct method again. So, therefore, by direct method, we will get minus 1 the whole square minus minus 1 plus 1 upon minus 1 the whole square plus 1, and here minus 1 minus 1. So I am applying direct method. Now this will become minus 1 square, that is plus 1 minus minus plus 1 plus 1 upon minus 1 square, that is plus 1 plus 1, that is 2, and this bracket is minus 2. So it will become 3 upon minus 4, and therefore the answer is minus 3 upon 4. Now here, if you will observe the factor which we have cancelled, then it is x plus 1 and the limit which is given here is minus 1. So here you can remember one hint, that whatever is the limit which is given in the question, you will get the factor which will be opposite in sign of that limit. So here we were having limit as minus 1, hence we are getting factor as plus 1. So answer is minus 3 upon 4. Thank you.